Hi, so today I'm gonna be doing Anastasia Beverly Hills Stick Foundation first review, and first I'm also gonna be showing you guys how it wears out throughout the day. I'm gonna be doing my everyday makeup while also talking to you guys about what I'm doing instead of doing a voiceover like I usually do. So yeah, this is a completed look right here. Everything that I'm using is mostly high-end, but there are plenty of drugstore alternatives that you can turn to, and I think I talk about some of them right here. So yeah, I hope that you guys like it, and let's get right to the video. I'm gonna be using it in two different ways. This side I'm gonna do it with a beauty blender, and this side I'm gonna be doing it with a brush. So the shade that I got is tan. I don't know if that's too dark for me. I'm going with my Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer. I have oily skin, or I think it's oily. It's not like terribly oily, but I call it oily, and I don't think that this primer really does a lot to control the oil. Okay, so now that we have this all over the face, I'm gonna go in with the foundation, and I'm just gonna apply it how I think you're supposed to apply it. So let's just start. Feels very smooth. It feels like the consistency of the professional primer, like silicone-y. And usually when I use a brush, I do spray it with some setting spray. So I'm gonna spray it with my Urban Decay just one time. So I don't know if this claimed to give full coverage or whatnot, but it looks pretty natural to me. As you can still see all my beauty marks, everything. So that's one side of my face. Now I'm gonna go in on the other side with my beauty blender. It does feel like it's a little bit harder to blend it with the beauty blender, which is not what how the beauty blender is supposed to work. And I feel like it is taking off a lot of product since it barely has coverage. And I feel like it's just hard to blend, and it's just, that's too time consuming for me. And in my NARS Creamy Concealer, I'm the shade Light 3 Honey. I feel like it's a little bit orangey for me, but you know, I needed to color correct, so that's fine. If you're trying to find a dupe for this, you don't want to pay, because it's honestly not anything better than a drugstore item. The Maybelline Fit Me concealers are like the same thing. I'm gonna be doing this away. I'm gonna go in with my Hourglass foundation and use it as concealer, because I accidentally got it in porcelain when I was trying to get it in bisque, so that sucks, but I heard that it's really good. So I just like to dab it like this, like the little triangles. This and that one right here. Now I'm going with my beauty blender again. I'm gonna blend this out first because I don't want it to dry. Also, all the places that I put this is where I'm gonna bake, just a little bit. I don't really bake like crazy. Okay, now I'm gonna bake. So I'm using the banana powder by Ben Eye, and I'm mixing it in with the Neutrogena Mineral Shears powder. quickly. Now while that's setting, I'm gonna start working on my eyeshadow. So first we're gonna start off with my handy dandy Anastasia World Traveler palette. And we're just gonna get soft peach and put it all over our lid. I'm gonna use this fluffy Sephora brush. I don't think it has a number. It's the Pro Airbrush Crease brush. And I'm gonna go in with my favorite Morocco. Then I'm gonna get out my Chocolate Bonbon palette by Too Faced. And I'm gonna go in with this shade right here called Bordeaux, something like that. This has a really good mirror, so I'm gonna just use that. I'm gonna just take a little bit and put it inner, but also everywhere as well. Then I'm gonna go in with my Anastasia palette and use my Morphe M411 to just get a really deep color in the crease, and I'm gonna use Red Ochre. Then I'm gonna go back with that same Sephora brush and blend everything out. So after the eyes are done, I'm gonna go in with my Tarte Precision Longwear Liner, but I'm not gonna do that on camera, so I'll be right back. So that's it for my eyeliner. And then if you guys are wondering what I use for my eyebrows, I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Pomade in the shade Chocolate. I'm gonna use this in the shade Chocolate. I'm gonna go in with this Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place Powder Makeup right underneath my eyes, just to set that in place a little bit more. And I'm gonna go in with this NYX Matte Bronzer and Deep Tan. I'm not really a huge fan of this, but gets the job done. Okay. Now we bathe. Toss my eyelashes, and if you do want to glam up the look a little bit, you can add some highlighter. So I'm gonna use this highlighter from the Anastasia Beverly Hills Concert Kit. And I'm gonna just highlight my nose a bit. Hey guys, so it's later on in the day. It's been about, I made the video at around 2 o'clock, and it's about 8. I'm not really oily, as you can see. Of course, my nose has a bit of highlight. But yeah, I feel like the foundation is holding up. It looks like it's oxidized to my skin tone. I don't really look that differently from skin wise. So far I like it when it's oxidized, not right first when you put it on. Coverage, not too good. Wear time, it's pretty good. It's been 5 hours, so if you go to school, you can wear it all day long with pretty much nothing happening. In total, I would probably give the foundation an 8 out of 10, just because I'm not bothered by how week the coverage is. I hope that you guys enjoy my video. I didn't really make a video because, like, I'm making this video for myself because I want the video out there. So if you don't like it, I really don't care. All up in my face, you're not from the clique. Give me space, we might ride the shit. Most say that.